Hi, parents. Happy Friday. We've made it through our first week of school. And I have to say, I think your students did a great job and you were very supportive with them. And I appreciate that because it made our week so successful. We're also very lucky to have Mrs. Middle and Ms. G to be in our class. They were an extra set of eyes and so helpful to me in so many ways and to your students as well. So we're also lucky that we have a great staff in our classroom this year. I wanted to talk to you about some changes that will be coming up and also let you know that things will become more consistent over the next few weeks. I have individual testing with your students to do, and then also I'm trying out different groups to see what will be the best fit for your student in the upcoming weeks. So be patient with me. I just ask, please give me those few weeks. I know it's easier to have one consistent schedule and one consistent time, but I want to do what will be most beneficial for the students. So I'll be trying out some different groupings over the next few weeks until we determine a placement that we'll use for several weeks. And with that being said, I've been emailing your students when they have their small group times. So if they look at their email every morning, kind of like they're walking into their classroom, they'll see an email invitation from me. So that's their email address through ETUSD, and that will show their time. Another way is to look at the Google Calendar. But if you look at the Google Calendar in Classroom and then in the Classwork tab, that will show their times for meeting with me as well. I saw the calendar of one of my students earlier today, and it was very specific for the day that there was the whole group meeting, the small group meeting, the whole group meeting, and then the student support time. So she wasn't confused that there were a lot of meeting times, because I've heard that some students have had that in their calendar and they didn't know which meeting to come to. So I'm not sure what the difference is, why it's specific for some students and other children maybe had all of the meetings that I've scheduled, which is typically six in a day. But please maybe check in the Google Classroom, in the Classwork section, and then the Google Calendar found there, and see if maybe your students' dates and times are very specific. Another thing that I want to tell you about is the upcoming platform change. As you know, every day this week, I've given your student a presentation or a slideshow, and it's very linear. So they could know to go from one activity to the next activity, and all the instructions were there for them. Next week, we'll be moving to the district platform, and it's not quite as specific day to day. And so I will need your help, because I don't want the students moving along or trying to complete all of their work on the first day, because they will have access to the material and the curriculum designed by the district teachers. So we will see how it works, and also I'll try to guide them through that work. As I've mentioned before, I'll always be there to support your students and do what I think is best for their development. One change to what I've already seen on the district platform is that I will be teaching math pretty much every day, and going by the system that I've used at Seaside Elementary School for nearly 20 years. It is a very meat and potato approach. They get very strong basics and foundational skills. We've had a lot of success with that system. What the district has provided is very enriching, but I will guide your students through that as well during our meetings. But I want them to have the strong foundation that will take them into the future. We'll all have to get used to the new platform, and having so much work available. But again, I'm there to guide your students, and I will do my best because there's a lot of materials that I have that I think they would enjoy as well. Some of the reading books that I've used that we can share together. What I also want to share while we're talking about the platform and something that I saw this week that we can all improve on is when the students are working or taking the work from their slides, I want them to start reading from the top all the way to the bottom, because sometimes they miss that final instruction as to click on the picture so that you can see the video, or submit this assignment by doing XYZ. That's a tool that we can all improve on. And finally, parents, I know that you have done a great job and you'll continue supporting your students. But overall, I want to be your student's teacher and I want you to be your child's parent. So I'm going to try to take as much responsibility on myself to teach your children, to provide age-appropriate and developmentally appropriate materials so that it takes some of the stress away from you. Yes, they will need your support. Yes, they will need your guidance. But two, I want you to be parents like we've known in the past, that when I ask you read with your child at night, that's your responsibility, not teaching throughout the entire day. So I hope you'll be patient with me as I finish getting some of the details together for this year. And I do appreciate that you've helped keep me informed as to what your children are doing and seeing or where they perhaps needed some help. Working together, we can really provide a great year for your children. Let's stay Seaside strong and have a good weekend. Rest up and be ready. Take care.